How you doing?
Good. Probably better than you.
Yeah, I'm just feel heavy. It's like, how high can you go in one day and low you can go a couple days later? It was like...
Yeah, my heart just...
I just feel bad for Tori. I just know how... man, Zach. Well, everything was going very well with the pregnancy. You sort of let your mind wander on how cute it would be to have another baby in the family, and then I was looking forward to being a grandpa again. And, yeah, it's tough to find out that, you know, I can't even imagine what Zach and Tori are going through. But yeah, got the call that something wasn't right. Zach called and said that things had taken a turn for the worse.
Do you don't know everybody reacts differently to situations? Do they want to be smothered in love? Do they want to have some privacy? Do they want to be, you know, you just right. It's kind of hard to know what to do.
Yeah. Well, I made it clear to Zach that I'm here and I, you know, I sign you up too.
Oh, that we're here. I said that too. Yeah, first thing.
We're here to, if we could just, you know, take the kids, you know, Jackson, Lila, whatever. So.
Yeah, and yet it might be a time when that's her most comforted thing is to be around her baby. So I just said, hey, laundry's piling up. I've actually brought over a bag of dinners and breakfast. And one thing, you know, they're not going to feel like probably doing for a couple days is like cooking and worrying about meals. So
the worst news you can get is when someone that you care about is hurting and you don't know what to do and you can't fix it. And so you just kind of take a deep breath and brace yourself to do and help them in whatever arises. And thank goodness their relationship is healthy and strong. And so we just kind of said, hey, we're here, and then took a step back and let them sort of decide what they needed. You don't want to push yourself on someone that isn't ready to discuss it. And yet you want to be there like, hey, here I am if you need me. So, you know, you walk a fine line, but you're hurting with them.
I got the phone call from Zachary. And tell you the truth, I really can't remember the exact words because I was just, really all I heard was that Tori had lost a baby. You know, and my heart broke. I was so, so very sad for them because I knew how excited they were. When I heard the news, there was really nothing I could say except I'm sorry. Just let me know what else I can do. I can't imagine how devastating it was for Tori to hear, having that instant, immediate attachment and just the joy and the wonder. And then, you know, suddenly to have that loss, I mean, that will stay with her for life, but in various ways, and some moments will come up and be very sad for her. You know, I texted Zach a couple of times, you know, not wanting to crowd Tori, because, you know, sometimes you just need your space. You just need that quiet time, that alone time, just your family time to kind of get through the process. Zach is definitely allowing her the time or the space or whatever Tori may need to get through or go through. And, you know, I think Tori will also appreciate Zach being there, but also, you know, just being there for Zach, because we often sometimes forget about the dad, and the dad may be on the sidelines, but it I'm sure it impacts him as well.
We were super excited for this pregnancy. It was like, oh, third one. Happened so quick. Like, we started telling friends and family pretty early. And, you know, Tori wasn't even 8 weeks yet. Or what's the weeks that you're supposed to do it?
12.
Yeah, it was supposed to be 12 weeks that you're, you know, maybe start announcing. And we were doing it at, like, week two. So, yeah, we didn't really think anything of it. Like, we're like, oh, you know, this is how it goes.
Watch this, guys.
Yeah, watch me.
Okay.
Or show
let's,
me.
Let's do it that way.
Can Daddy do it, actually, real quick?
No, let him do it. He hasn't done it yet. Go. Go.
Wow.
I don't know. Like, the first couple weeks, I was feeling pretty sick. But then, leading up to the doctor's appointment, I had been feeling better, which in hindsight, I guess, wasn't a good thing. But okay.
A little further.
We were in the ultrasound, and it was all standard. You get there, they rub the stuff on the belly, and the machine starts going, and then just the tone of the ultrasound tech and just the tone of the room kind of shifted, and you realize maybe something's not right here.
You know, she can't give it away because she's an ultrasound tech. Like, that's not her job. But, you know, she said sorry.
Yeah,
she said sorry. And left the room.
Yeah.
And so then we had to wait for my doctor, you know, and she came in and gave me a hug and, you know, we just knew. You know, everyone says it's nothing that I did or that we did. It was just, this baby wasn't viable for life, but it's hard to, like, you know, not wonder, like, what happened on that day or, you know, but it is, like, it is common. You know, it happens to more people than you think, but you just never think it's going to happen to you, especially after having 2 full-term babies and 0 complications. And I think that's why it just, like, hit us, especially me, so hard. I just feel so normal already, and I think that that's really hard for me to, like, I think that's just been the hardest part, too, is it's just how quickly it's all happened, and just, you know, I just feel normal again, and that's hard. Yeah.
Jackson!
It's upsetting to watch Tori go through something like this. It brings about a new empathy for, yeah, women. We've heard stories, but it clicks differently now. I just worry about Tori. She lived 8 weeks of feeling like she was pregnant, and now she's not. I wanted to support her however I can. It's about Tori and how much time she needs to process it.